In this video, you will learn about GNOME JavaScript documentation and GNOME UI source code. If you know how to read the documentation, you don't need to watch this video. This video is more useful for those who cannot read the documentation or the source code. This website is a place to find almost everything you need for developing GNOME extensions. For example, you can find BN inside ST. We used BN in our first extension to create a button in panel. At the top of the page, you can see which objects BN inherited from. In the first tutorial, we used setChild from BN. You can learn about inputs and outputs here. If you go to the st.widget, you can see where I found a style class for the first tutorial. And because BN is inherited from widget, we can use widget inside BN directly. For example, we can use set a style class name to change the CSS class name. As you can see, I used set a style class name inside BN. If something has been added to the new version or deprecated, you will be notified like this. We used GTK box in previous tutorial. For knowing about GTK, you just need to select GTK and read the section you need. At the left side, you can enable the item you want to read. In the first tutorial, we used main from UI. At the moment, there isn't any documentation for UI, and you have to read the source code to know about it. Now, I want to show you how you can find panel.writebytes in main. This is the UI source code. Everything you can import and use is here. This is the main that we used in our first extension code. Inside this file, we can see the main.panel will be the panel class inside panel.js file. Inside panel.js file, we can find panel class. It has writebytes in it and holds bytes layout from ST. Now we know we can insert a child to the writebytes. Unfortunately for now, this is the only way we can find out about the UI.